we're very thankful that they have made it here and made this tour possible. The Honorable Minister of Telecommunication, Foreign Employment and Sports, Mr. Harin Fernando. We also have Mr. Shami Silva, who is the President of Sri Lanka Cricket. Mr. Mohan D. Silva, Honorary Secretary, Sri Lanka Cricket. And of course, Chairman of Pakistan Cricket Board, Mr. Hassan Mani. I'll hand it over to Mr. Mani first for his opening and welcome comments.
Okay. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum. मैं आज अंग्रेज़ी में बात करूंगा बिकॉज़ हमारे बाहर के मेहमान आए हुए हैं बट ऑब्वियसली इफ़ यू हैव क्वेश्चंस लेटर ऑन तो आई विल बी हैप्पी टू टेक देम आई थॉट दिस वाज एन द राइट मोमेंट टू एक्नॉलेज द सपोर्ट दैट श्रीलंका क्रिकेट हैज़ गिवन टू अस एज पाकिस्तान क्रिकेट दिस वाज अ वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टूर फॉर अस एंड आई एम वेरी ग्रेटफुल टू मिनिस्टर हारिन फर्नांडो शामी सिल्वा एंड मोहन डी सिल्वा for the way they've supported Pakistan cricket. They have been absolutely exceptional in their support for Pakistan and for Pakistan cricket. They knew how important it was for this tour to take place. So I'm really, sir, very grateful to you for doing this and to you, Shami. Without your support, this tour would not have been possible. Today is, you know, there's no, it's so important that the game wins over any threats and terrorism and so on. We've seen this in Christchurch recently, that was terrible. There were incidences in Sri Lanka, but these can happen anywhere in the world. The main thing is that the security and safety of the players cannot be compromised. So it was important that the Sri Lankan board was comfortable. And I'm very grateful to the security delegation that came to Pakistan, and Mr. Mohan De Silva, who's now the Honorary Secretary of the Board, and was formerly a chairman of the Board of Sri Lanka, came to Pakistan with security consultants and did an extensive review, not only in Karachi, but also Lahore. They were satisfied. We've since then had other people who come from Australia, and we've got people coming from a couple of other countries, and the feedback we're getting is positive. But it was so important for us as Pakistan for this tour to take place. Sri Lanka has a special place in our hearts. They suffered here in Pakistan. We must never forget that. And for them to come is a great, great act of courage for them to come forward and support Pakistan cricket. So I just want, in front of all of you, I wanted to acknowledge this. It is an exceedingly important series for Pakistan, and inshallah we'll build from this and, you know, go from strength to strength so that all our cricket is played in this country. You've already seen that even on a Monday, the crowd turnout has been very good. It's you know, it's been fantastic. And this is something that our players are just not used to by playing in the Middle East, where if you're lucky, about 15-20% of the ground will be full. So to have cricket in Pakistan, have Sri Lanka here, is a very special day for me. Thank you. Please, if you can.
Assalamu alaikum. I think it gives us great pleasure to be in Pakistan. I think just like Mr. Hassan Mani mentioned, cricket has become a universal game, and it's not just about the competitiveness, but it's also showing solidarity amongst the neighboring nations. And I think I'm very grateful to the Sri Lankan government also, who was involved with this, allowing Sri Lankans to play in Pakistan. As you all know, Sri Lankans also have a very large Muslim community, and we live in very much in harmony. And first and foremost, I want to thank the Pakistan Cricket Board, which, when we had a situation on April 21st, sending an under-19 team into Sri Lanka when things were not even settled in Sri Lanka. So that was an act of solidarity that was shown by the Pakistanis to Sri Lanka, even though we had to go through 10 years ago a situation where we faced, and some players were still in shock and didn't want to play, but we as a cricket board, the sports ministry and the government decided, as long as the security is perfect and as long as the Pakistan Cricket Board is taking care of our boys, we should not be worried. And I myself wanted to come today simply to show that the boys, also to show that we were supporting them and we'll be right behind them. And I see it's a good opportunity for young Sri Lankan boys also to play here today, who have been knocking on the conversation. And I'm interested and keen to watch the next session of the game, where how the boys will play their cricket. What amazes me is the amount of security that have been given, and how they've looked after, and even the command center down at this stadium is high tech, and it's amazing. And to see that you will recognize every grade, every gate, every aspect, every person who gets into the ground and get out of the ground, it's being monitored. So. And these things, like Mr. Shan Mani said, could happen anywhere in the world, but life has to go on, we have to move on, and sport should not stop. And I believe the other players, other countries also will send their players in. There's Pakistani cricket, and they're fantastic, they're always good competitors. It's always good to play with Pakistan, and I hope that Sri Lanka will do that.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Shall we want to say a few words?
Actually, yeah. I have nothing much to say. My minister has told everything. Yeah. But I'm very glad, you know, I'm very glad, and even I'm very supportive of your former ICC chairman and now chairman of your PCB. I was following him from long time. So our Sri Lanka Cricket Board, our 200% support is with you. Whatever you all have, I think your security is too tight. I can't go out. I'm a little worried about that. So anyway, my minister has told everything. You know, Sri Lanka is behind with you all, and we will support you all anytime. Thank you.
Thank you. I just like to add, I was speaking to Mr. Shami Selva a little while ago, and he tells me he knows Pakistan well. He's been coming here over the years. He's a squash player. So he's been to Peshawar, he's been to Rawalpindi, have you been to Lahore?
Yeah.
So he knows Pakistan well. The point here I'm making is that the perception of a country sitting outside is very different to when you actually go and visit a place. So it's important for us to get people to come and see Pakistan for what it is. And I'm very grateful to the Australian Cricket Board. They sent their chief executive and head of security recently. Their chairman has promised to come to Pakistan in the near future. Similarly, the English Cricket Board are sending their chief executive and a board director to come and have a look. And then we've got Cricket Ireland, who we didn't even mention to about getting people in, offered to come themselves. New Zealand have been speaking to us. So the message is getting across, and this is why this tour was so important for us. We can all say things are fine, come and have a look, but when cricket is actually taking place in Pakistan, there cannot be a better endorsement than that. And again, I'd like to thank Sri Lanka Cricket Board for that.
Just to add up to Mr. Shanmani, my first experience coming to Pakistan was way back when I was a kid at 15 years. I came for the 1996 World Cup final in Lahore, and I still, it echoes in my ear when the whole of Pakistan was cheering Sri Lanka against Australia, saying Sri Lanka Zindabad. And I still remember the entire game. I tried to jump into the ground, and I got a baton hit on my back as well, by cop at that time. So the great memories of Pakistan, and I think the friendship should remain, and the boys seems to be very comfortable, so that's what matters to us.
Mr. Mohandeep Silva, would you like to share your thoughts?
Yes, thank you very much. As you all know, Sri Lankans are very warm-hearted and very hospitable as a nation. And Sri Lanka and Pakistan have continued to enjoy a very strong and cordial relationship dating back many years. And we are also a nation of grateful people, because we remember how Pakistan came to our assistance when we were in difficulty, not only in cricket, but in many other ways. And of course, way back in 1980s, Pakistan wholeheartedly supported us along with India to obtain test status. Then as the Honorable Minister mentioned, you all send your under-19 team. Just after the outbreak of violence we experienced. With all that, I think we must also thank the Pakistan Pakistan government for ensuring such a high level of security, which is compatible to a head of state. And we did come here about a month or two ago and experienced the presentations made by your police chiefs and the personnel. Important thing is to implement them. So we are convinced that all those what was promised has been delivered. And we also have to mention here that as Asian countries, we believe in unity, and for the sake of protect, we have to be united. And we also have obligations towards fulfilling our commitments with international cricket. And I'm happy to say that my president, Shamil Silva, as we went back and convinced them about the security measures taken here, he wholeheartedly, along with my executive committee, agreed with the permission of the government to send this team here. And in this context, I must mention the support extended by the Honorable Minister. If not, I don't think we would have been in a position to send our team and also the Sri Lanka government, because as you all know, there's a lot of pressure from various quarters, politically and otherwise. But I must say we are happy that we have come, and Minister himself coming here is a huge endorsement of the respect that Sri Lanka has towards Pakistan and the PCB. So thank you very much, Mr. Mani. You have been a personal friend of mine for many years, and the support you extended to me. So we are happy to be here, and I must thank all of you for the support extended to the national team. Thank you.
Thank you very much, gentlemen. We'll now take a few questions first.
Mr. Shami Silva, Pakistani people and Pakistan's cricket administrators, they are really grateful for the Sri Lankans to visit Pakistan. Now you have come for the ODI and T20 series. When are you going to decide about the test series which is going to be held in December? Are you coming to Pakistan? Or you'll have to take some time to decide about that?
Yeah, that's fine.
Actually, security-wise, you know, we don't need to think twice. But we have to think about test. We are playing the test championship. So if the three or four players can't, if they tell, because still we have 2009, say the incident, what happened, there are three, four players are there. So they are in the testing. So we have to take a call, and we will talk to Mr. Mani and my minister. When I forget to tell you, you know, government was getting, you know, this problem about 7 days, 8 days, it was delaying, and then the Pakistan Cricket Board was pressurizing us. Minister said, we'll take a chance and we'll go, right? He was telling me, we'll take a chance and we'll go. So you know about the security, and we have sent the security team and our former Air Force Marshal, you know, we send him, so we knew about security, and he said we'll take a chance and go. So like that, test matches also, I hope, you know, all the players will agree to come. So then I think, you know, we have no problem to come to Pakistan at all.
Just to add up to it, I think what matters is that the players are in Pakistan.
Yep.
And these players play along with the senior players as well, or the few players who did not make it. And they myself will endorse how well the security was organized and how well Pakistan has treated us well. And so that will be also a confidence booster. So I thought this tour had to happen if we had to play test series also here. So I think I'm quite positive. And I spoke to the boys before the game. I'm constantly on WhatsApp with them. Even the time that they were coming from the airport, they're sending me pictures. So I kept a good relationship with the boys, speaking to them, making them comfortable. See, you know, everybody have families back at home, and families might be a bit worried. I mean, it's not as bad as people say. Pakistan is quite safe. Me and my president slowly wanted to get out of the security and go for shopping, but we couldn't do that because there's too much of people around us, and we are quite used to walking around, and I saw the streets. It looks perfectly fine.
My question is, Sri Lankans are always very supportive and favorable relation, and I'm sure this series will go very successfully in the end. But does it affect only other teams like Australia, England, change their mindset after the series? Do you think that, how positive you are about it?
Look, I just said that the chief executive of Cricket Australia has already been to Pakistan with his security consultant, who was also here for the PSL matches. And now the chairman of Cricket Australia wants to come. And we are looking at a home series for us in 2022. So we are already planning that far ahead. You can't do these things overnight. So you've got to win the confidence of the board first of all, because they are responsible for the safety of their players. After that, the players, and then the players rely on their, certainly in Australia, they rely on their players' association. We're going to invite the representatives from the Australian Player Association to also come and have a look at Pakistan. So this is step by step. Issue a step we have to take to gain the confidence, but I cannot overemphasize the impact of Sri Lanka coming here, because they have now opened the door. It's for us as Pakistan to make sure that the standards that we have given Sri Lankan board remain consistent and are there for the others. We've been doing this with the PSL. It's not the first time we're doing it. So I'm confident that the message that's going out is a strong and powerful one. जो हमने agree किया था, what we'd discussed certainly with Mr. Shami Silva and the Sri Lankan board, was let's first deal with these one-day series, the white ball cricket, and then we'll reassess on both sides. And obviously, a test championship is important for everyone, so we can't disadvantage them totally by saying no, we have a hard view. It'll be a joint, hopefully, a consensus. And I sincerely hope that the players who are here will act as ambassadors for Pakistan by going back and giving their version of security. So it's very much something that we will be talking in a couple of months, but we've got Bangladesh coming in between these series. And I'm hoping that by having them here, we will also convey a similar message to the world.
What happened was we agreed to play initially, myself and Mr. Mani, only 3 T20s. But anyway, I spoke to my minister and my executive committee, and because it has to be, we have to give you all a bigger, show the other guys bigger picture, then we agreed to play an extra 3 matches as well.
My question is for the Sri Lankan board officials. The narrative from the Sri Lankan side is very certainly and very obviously positive, but 10 players did not opt to come for the series. So why has this narrative not reciprocated for those players? What is going on in their mind? What do they think is falling short for them?
Well, let me just answer that. I think not out of all the 10 would have been selected. So the players who were in the pool that decided, a few of them didn't want to come. But there were a few players who actually experienced something in 2009. And as I said, as I mentioned, certain decisions had to be taken with the family's consent. And probably the players who actually went through it had that fear of psychosis working in their minds, and they didn't want to move forward of that. But what we have done, what is very positive, as Mr. Mani explained as well, these boys who came today are also not A players or A division players. Most of them played inside out of the national team. Why I was more excited for them was because they got a very good opportunity to knock on the door and put the senior players with a lot of pressure. And if they do well, it's good for Sri Lanka cricket. So, always risk return is profit. So you take a risk, you come here, you play your cricket, and you do well, you'll be in the national team and you'll seal your position. So what I think what happened with the senior players was that simply it was a family concern, and we needed to respect their thoughts as well. What we wanted was to go ahead, and I'm very excited with this young team, because teams have to move on, you know, they have to get the new young infusion into the side. So I think this is an ideal opportunity for Sri Lanka. Even if we don't win, we will definitely figure a few players out, and that will do well for Sri Lanka cricket, and that's a positive way to see, and I think they will challenge. I mean, Pakistan is a very good side. Playing in Pakistan is a challenge. So you need boys who can play with challenges.
My question is for Chairman Mani. Both you and the Sri Lankan board officials, all of them mentioned the importance of having absolutely strict security to ensure that the series goes ahead. Do you think that the time when cricket in Pakistan can take place in slightly more, perhaps, relaxed circumstances is still quite far away?
No, I don't think so. It might take a couple of years. It's not so much a concern about the security in Pakistan. It's more about comfort levels for the players and for our visitors. As they get more comfortable with Pakistan, they themselves will be saying, okay, we don't need this level of security. I saw that with the PSL. Some of the overseas players, and we had 35 or 32 overseas players who took part in the PSL here. By the end, they were sneaking off without security. And our security people were chasing around looking for them. But that's a good thing.
Yeah.
Because it shows that they were comfortable. They were going to parties, to dinners, to restaurants, but making sure the security didn't know they were going. So they felt confident enough to do that. So inshallah, the time will come.
So I also remember Sri Lanka went through similar situations.
Yeah.
I remember there was a bomb blast that took place right opposite Taj Samudra Hotel in Colombo when the New Zealand team was there. So Sri Lanka, this is nothing new for our part of the world, most probably. India, Sri Lanka, Pakistan, we all share the same sentiments. We have this security threat right around the clock. And so what we need to do is, as people, give the maximum security, maximum intelligence involved in it. And that, as I said, see, what was really encouraged me was how the command center works here, how much they monitor people. See, a modern world would do that, and Pakistan had got in the right direction, and Sri Lanka needs to do it as well. See, we monitor, I mean, there are technologies, because I'm also the telecommunication and was the digital minister in Sri Lanka. I know how you can scan irises, I can scan people, you know exactly who's coming, who's going out. So as long as things move on that direction, I'm sure Pakistan will have all countries coming and playing in here.
Hello, Muzamil from Yarwa here. I just want to ask that a lot of talks are there about security situation, but you have seen the crowd here today in Karachi Stadium. What are your thoughts on this enthusiastic crowd? And Mr. Mani, I want to ask that what you guys are doing to make sure that you are not interested in paying extra money to the players who want to visit Pakistan in future?
Okay, I'll answer first. As I said, I have still good memories of Pakistan and the Pakistan crowd, and even today, as we walked into the ground for the national anthems, the way they supported, they cheered the Sri Lankan team, even after the national anthem. These are things that I wanted Sri Lankans to see as well and the rest of the world. See, Pakistan is our friends, and friends of cricketing nations, and Pakistan have been always competitive. And using this incident, using this situation to just to not come here and play and not have that advantage, I think it's a slightly not correct, and it's advisable for the game of cricket or the passion that the cricketers or the players or the countries have for each other. So I think the people of Pakistan are not enemies of anybody, and they simply love their cricket. They come here to watch the cricket, and the cricketers should play their cricket. And the boards, the government should make sure that the players are safe, and things should move on. That's my take, I should say.
Okay, as far as your second part of your question was, the simple answer is no. We will not pay anyone extra money to come and play. Because if it's a matter of money, then it's not a matter of security.
Manisa, my question is related to the holding of the PSL next year. Do you think that will be a litmus test of Pakistan's security when we stage the one-month tournament and the foreign player will be coming in, and that will send a very positive message if it's staged successfully?
Well, it's a step in the right direction. In terms of security, the level of security for the PSL is not as high as it is for this tour, but for different reasons. It's excellent security and more than adequate. As I told you, the players were getting fed up and they were trying to go off on their own. there's no doubt we have a couple of extra venues now. We're going to have four venues of the PSL against two. But eventually, there are about eight places in Pakistan where international cricket is being capable of being played. We're a big country. And we have over 220 million people. And they're desperate to watch cricket. If, you know, to build cricket from the grassroots levels, you've got to go and play there, attract the young kids, be the role, you know, they when they see their role models, their iconic players coming to play in front of them, it just changes the whole dynamics of cricket in the country. So for us, it's important to reach out. Obviously, security of the players is paramount, and we will never compromise on that.
Last question.
My question to Mr. Shami. We must say thanks to you as you are helping to restore international cricket in Pakistan. Earlier you sent your team for T20 and now your ODI team is in here in Karachi. Will you help PCB again to organize Asia Cup T20 as it's Pakistan turns next year? Will you help, will you become advocate for Pakistan to convince other countries they must come here as you are witness the security level and the patient
Yeah, definitely, you know, because we are in the Asian Cricket Council, we are like the brothers, so we will try to support all the countries. If Sri Lanka is having, everybody is coming there, so same way, you know, if they have the Asian Cricket Championship, Sri Lanka will be definitely there. So others, their government, they have to take it. Call. So we will be there definitely.
Also, just to add up, I think PCB is very smart. They've got Sri Lanka here and Bangladesh is coming, two countries,
exactly.
The main two countries are here. So if the others want to stay out, it's fine. We still will play the Asia Cup.
I don't have to say anything more. You know, the main thing is that cricket and politics shouldn't mix.
Exactly.
You know, cricket is a sport that brings people together. It reaches out. There's no border for cricket. You know, where it's being played is irrelevant. So the important thing here is to make sure that the cricketing fraternity stays together, you know, for what they are there for, to play the game. What the politicians want to do is beyond our control, but obviously it can have an impact. And we'll assess that at the time if the situation arises.
Thank you very much, gentlemen. Thank you.
Thank you.